Dear children, welcome back to our online English class, part 14. In the previous class, we studied the lesson 4, a poem, Who Has Seen the Wind? Today, before starting the poem, I would like to give you a dictation. Take the last page of your English notebook. Last time, where did you write the dictation words? Near to that page. You write dictation lesson 4. Let's start the dictation. First word, wind. Write the word wind. Finished. Second one, hang. The second word is hang. Third one, trembling. Third one, trembling. Finished. Next. Fourth one, trees. The fourth word is trees. Fifth one, bow. The fifth word is bow. Sixth one, heads. What is the sixth word? Heads. And the last one, seventh one, see. The last word is see. Once again, I'll read all the words. Listen. One, wind. Two, hang. Three, trembling. Four, trees. Five, bow. Six, heads. Seven, see. Did you finish? Now, let's check the spelling. Okay. Dictation, lesson 4. What is the first word? One, wind. Spell the word wind. W-I-N-D. Wind. Check it. If it is correct, put a tick mark. If it is correct, put a tick mark. If it is wrong, what will you do? Put a cross mark. Okay. The first word is wind and the spelling W-I-N-D. And what is the second one? Hang. Spell the word hang. H A N G. Hang. Check the spelling. Hang. H A N G. If it is correct, put a tick mark. Third one, trembling. Third one, trembling. T R E M B L I N G. Trembling. T R E M B L I N G. Trembling. Check the spelling. Then fourth one, trees. Fourth one, trees. T-R-E-E-S. T-R-E-E-S. Then fifth one. Fifth one, bow. B-O-W. Spelling is, here the spelling is O, but we have to pronounce it as bow. Ow sound. Okay, bow. Okay, bow. The next, sixth word, heads. Okay, what's the word? Heads. Spell the word heads. H-E-A-D-S. Then the seventh one, the last one. The last word is C. Okay, have you made all words correct? Okay, if you got full marks, put 7 out of 7. Put marks. And if you made any answer, any word wrong, write that word correctly. And how many times will you write? 5 times. 5 times you write in the copy and send this dictation page and the copy pages to me. Okay. Now, let's continue the poem. Who has seen the wind? Did you read the poem? I hope you read it many times. Now I'm going to read the poem. All of you listen carefully. Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. The poem is written by Christina Rossetti. Now, one of your friends, Sarah Elizabeth Shibu, will read the poem, Who Has Seen the Wind?
Who Has Seen the Wind? A poem by Christina Rossetti. Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by.
Now, I would like to ask you some questions. Can anybody see the wind? Have you seen the wind? No, we cannot see the wind. Nobody has seen the wind. It is not something that we can see. What do the leaves do when the wind passes by? What do the leaves do? The leaves tremble in the wind. What do the leaves do? All of you say, you try to say. What do the leaves do when the wind passes by? The leaves tremble in the wind. And what do the trees do when the wind passes by? What do the trees do? The trees bow down their heads. The trees bow down their heads when the wind passes by. Once again, I will explain this poem for you. Listen. Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. Who has seen the wind? Have you seen the wind? No. Nobody has seen the wind. It is not something that we can see. Neither I nor you. Yes, I didn't see the wind. You also didn't see the wind. We cannot see the wind. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. How can we tell if the wind is passing by? How can we tell if the wind is passing by? But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Yes, when the wind is passing by, we feel the cold touch of the wind. And here the poet says, the leaves tremble in the wind. Then we can tell the wind is passing by. But when the leaves hang trembling, the leaves shake, the leaves move in the wind. Tremble, shake. The leaves tremble in the wind. When the leaves tremble in the wind, we can say, we can tell the wind is passing by. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. Again, the poet is saying, we cannot see the wind. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. The wind is sometimes very strong. The wind is sometimes stronger than the trees because it can make the trees bow down their head when it passes by. Okay, bow down their heads. Bow down, bent down. Heads. In the last class I told you, really trees do not have heads. But the poet is comparing the top portion of the trees to our heads. Like our heads, the tree is moving in the wind. The top portion of the tree is full of leaves, like our hair. Okay, that's why here the poet is compared the top portion of the tree to our head. Here, but when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. When it is a heavy wind, it makes the trees bow down their heads, bend down their heads. Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. Have you understood the poem? Now, let's study the meanings and sentences. Tremble. Tremble. What's the meaning? Tremble. Shake. Tremble means shake. Rakhiga, ilagya anta parayille. Tremble. What's the meaning? Shake. We can use this word in a sentence. The boy trembled with fear. The boy trembled. You can underline this word. The boy trembled with fear. What is the sentence? The boy trembled with fear. Tremble. What's the meaning? Shake. Use the word in a sentence. You can make any sentence. Now you read this sentence. The boy trembled with fear. The boy trembled with fear. Put a full stop. Okay. Next one. Bow. B-O-W. B-O-W. What's the meaning? Bend. Bend. Bow down. Bent down. And we can use this word in a sentence. The tree bowed in the wind. The tree bowed in the wind. You have to underline the word we used in sentence. Okay. Bow means bent. Bow down. Bend down. The tree bowed in the wind. Next we can study the verb forms. Present tense, past tense and past participle form. Present tense, past tense, past participle. See. So. See, so. See. See, so, see. Second one. Hand. Hand. Hung, hung. Hang, hung, hung. Third one. Pass. Passed. Bow, bowed, bowed, then five, tremble. 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 Let's read this verb forms once again. See, saw, seen. See, saw, seen. Hang, hung, hung. Pass, passed, passed. Bow, bowed, bowed. Tremble, trembled, trembled. Have you understood these verb forms? Now let's study the opposites. Up. What is the opposite of this word up? Up, down. What's opposite? Unseen. UNSEEN. Up, down, seen, unseen. Okay? Now let's study what are rhyming words. Okay. Rhyming words. What are rhyming words? Rhyming words are the words which are ending with the same sound. Rhyming words are ending with the same sound. Same sound, that is important. Same sound. They are ending with the same sound. Rhyming words are ending with the same sound. Sound is very important. Okay, not the spelling. We have to listen to the sound. Rhyming words are ending with the same sound. Find words in the form that rhyme with these words. Bean, ban, shoe. Bean. Bean, to hang, not to hang, ban, ban, tree, shoe, shoe. Bean, which word in this form is rhyming with this word bean? You find out which word in this form is rhyming with this word bean. Try to find out. Who has seen the wind? Neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. Bean. Yes. Say, which word is rhyming with this word bean? Seen. Yes. Seen. Yes, they are ending with the same sound. Bean, seen. Okay, next. Ban. Which word in this form is rhyming with this word ban? To find out, say. Yes, what's that word? Hang. Okay, hang. H-A-N-G. Hang. Yes, both the words are ending with the same sound. Ban, hand. Okay, next. Shoe, shoe. Which word in this form is rhyming with this word shoe? Yes, what is that? You. Okay, what is that? You, Y-O-U. Both are ending with the same sound, not the spelling. Shoe, you. Okay, have you understood? Rhyming words are ending with the same sound. Okay.
Has seen the wind. have seen the wind, neither I nor you. But when the leaves hang trembling, the wind is passing through. Who has seen the wind? Neither you nor I. But when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. Christina Rossetti.
Who has seen the wind? Do you want to have some fun in the wind? Make and fly a kite. Blow bubbles, see which direction the wind takes them. When the wind blows, run with it. Next, run against the wind and feel the thrill. Make wind chimes out of old spoons, forks, cans, bells, shells and whatever you can find. Listen to the music it creates when the wind blows. Fly paper planes. Sail your toy boats, see where the wind takes them. Play Frisbee. Now, let's discuss these questions. What's the first question? How can we tell if the wind is passing by according to the poem? What's the question? How can we tell if the wind is passing by according to the poem? What is the answer? You try to say, according to the poem, when the leaves tremble and the trees bow down their heads, we can tell the wind is passing by. What's the answer? According to the poem, when the leaves tremble and the trees bow down their heads, we can tell the wind is passing by. What is the second question? What are the other ways by which we know that the wind is passing by? What are the other ways by which we know that the wind is passing by? We can tell the wind is passing by when the clothes on the clothesline move up and down
and the windows close on their own. Close on their own, what's the meaning? Taniye adayuga alle aaru adakkada taniye adayuga. When the windows close on their own. What is the third question? Which is stronger, a tree or the wind? Which part of the poem tell us this? The wind is sometimes stronger than the trees because the wind can make the trees bow down their heads when it passes by. The lines from the poem that tell us this are, but when the trees bow down their heads, the wind is passing by. Let's think, answer these questions. Has anyone seen the wind? Why can't we see the wind? Has anyone seen the wind? No, nobody has seen the wind. Why can't we see the wind? Nobody has seen the wind because it is not something we can see. It is not something we can see. What is the second question? Do trees really have heads? What does the speaker mean? What is the hint given here? Think of how a tree looks and how it moves. What is the answer? I told you, I explained to you. Trees do not really have heads. But their top portion, which is full of leaves, looks just like our heads, which are covered in hair. Also, just like our heads, the leaves of the trees can move too. Okay, have you understood? Look at this picture. Write a few lines to describe what you can see in the picture. What is happening because of the wind? You look at the picture and write a few lines in the notebook. How can we describe the picture? What is happening in the picture? The wind is blowing. And what is a girl doing? There is a girl running and enjoying the windy day. It is a windy day. The girl is running and enjoying the windy day. The girl's hair and clothes are flying in the wind. The trees are also moving in the wind. And their leaves are flying too. The girl is running past a clothesline. And what happened to the clothes? The clothes are flapping in the wind. And there are two kites. There are two kites being blown about by the wind too. Yes, the two kites are being blown about by the wind. Blown about. Kaatave parthikundu povaanu le. There are two kites being blown about by the wind too. Okay, have you understood this poem?
Dear children, I hope you could understand the lesson for the poem, Who Has Seen the Wind? Study very well. Write and study. Don't make any spelling mistakes. Read the poem many times loudly at home. Thank you.